I don't know why, but I thought that elevator was going to go down into the well.
Oh, no.
Oh, that would be ridiculous. Why would you go down in a well?
I don't know.
I can't think of anything you might find at the bottom of a well.
Yeah, this lady's just trying to iron your clothes and you shoot her in the face.
She thought you looked a little wrinkly.
Yes, iron. We'll go with that.
No, that's definitely what that was.
Oh no, don't jump me like that.
Holy shit.
That happened.
I had a feeling there was a firebomb person there.
Nice.
Welp.
I work at a fast food joint that is similar to Wendy's. So today, I worked drive-thru coordinating and taking money. We're swamped by kids in the dining area, as we're right down the street from a middle and high school, and today was their second day back from school. I was rushing, as corporate is anal about drive-thru times, and I had a lady order a junior cheeseburger and four-piece. We'd run out of honey mustard, and I politely informed her of this. She asked me what other sauces we had, and I gave her the list, and she yelled, "Just give me ranch." I know she's going to be one of those customers. She pulls up, and as we begin assembling her order, I tell her her total and give her her change. But as I'm rushing, I drop one penny, and it goes under her car. I smile nervously and proceed to tell her, "I'm sorry, it was just a penny, don't worry about it." I turn to get her bag, and when I turn back, she has opened her car door and gotten out. The girl taking orders is staring at her as she tries to pry the window open and bangs on it, staring at me. I'm confused at this point, and open the window to give her her food, and she glares and goes, "Do you tell all your customers not to worry about their change?" At this point, I'm floored. She's out of her car and yelling at me over a penny. She snatches the bag, gets back in her car, and yells that she'll never come back again, and speeds off, almost into traffic. Good lord. I know I dropped a coin, but it was just a goddamn penny.
Some people are nuts about their change, I guess.
Yeah.
I agree that it's kind of ridiculous to go to that extreme over a penny, but I absolutely can see and understand somebody doing that.
I have had situations at my job where someone will argue about, you know, $10 or $12, which is not an insignificant sum of money to me, on an order that routinely will break $1,000. The phrase a nickel holding up a dollar gets brought up regularly. What I'm saying is I see this sort of behavior a lot.
Yeah.
People are real devoted about their money. Let's put it that way.
I get being thrifty. I get that being thrifty is how you get more money. But come on. Relax once in a while.
Yeah.
Your blood pressure will thank you.
Better go get it. Our gate is getting away.
Ooh. I got it.
Oh, he broke the pitchforks. Now how will the angry mob form?
They'll figure something out. I mean, I haven't done anything to their torches.
You have all their torches.
So, what's your point? I haven't done anything to them, except possess them.
Although, speaking of torches, have you considered using one instead of your tiny lantern that doesn't actually give you any light?
It's giving me enough.
Here in this area that is, you know, basically Ooh. Pitch black.
I've never seen a wheelchair man book it like that before.
Yeah, he was moseying.
He really wanted to get me.
I've always seen them just hanging out and waiting.
Well, I'm sure we'll see him again.
Oh no. We might have made a miscalculation about welcoming invasions.
What?
You just passed up the point where the sinister bell ringing lady is supposed to be, and she was not there.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
Well, he rang the bell himself. She doesn't need to be there.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think she shows up until somebody actually does start in. Shit. Oh, no. We'll have to figure this out later, I guess.
We may have to do some testing. Important testing. I'm not saying that I'm willing to be a sacrificial lamb here, but I'm pretty bad at Bloodborne.
Ooh.
Come to me, Brickman.
I'm surprised I counted that as a hit on me.
I find it insane that you can take so many hits. But then again, I don't think I put a single point into anything that wasn't strength.
Always be strength and all that.
Yeah.
To be fair, I didn't have to hit things very often.
Wow, these trees are really,
Yeah.
They're doing some work.
That's pretty great. You just look up from stabbing a dog, and then just, that tree's on fire.
I wonder how a thing like that could have happened.
Spontaneous combustion.
Oh yeah, yeah, that must be it.
I'm gonna keep moving.
Yeah, you figured out what you were standing on there?
Yeah.
Maybe don't stand on those. It's kind of rude.
Impolite. Has Argate enjoyed these guys' company before?
No, they seem new.
Okay.
Well, you've seen one, but you haven't seen them actively in your way yet.
Oh, the one from, like, right next to the Central Yharnam,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
that
the
is correct.
Of Central Yharnam?
Oh, that's mean of him, right there. Mm-hmm.
No, that's not gonna do you any good.
I thought it would, but nope. Oh, hey, that gate.
Yes.
Yes, that gate.
Yes. That gate.
You know, the one.
Did the pebble just sort of donk off him and fall?
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
Ooh, if thought that wide sweep was gonna hit you.
Oh. You're getting real good at that that parry that doesn't actually accomplish anything.
And he dodged it that time.
Oh no! There you go.
I don't know how many. That's like five parries on him before I got the visceral. See, I saw a dog or two over here.
Hey, you should go pet them dogs.
A third one.
Yeah, you want to check out the path of the dog.
That's a lot of dogs.
Path yes. of the dog.
Enjoy perhaps, the dog. Love the perhaps, dog.
Perhaps consider using a weapon type that has a large sleeping bag.
Perhaps consider your timing.
Ooh.
Also, yes, perhaps consider not fighting all of them at once.
They all decided to come at me.
Bro, I don't know what to tell you.
Ooh.
Ah, that was actually kind of close.
Ooh.
You were down to one.
Oh, no!
Alright, I want to try something. This time, try ringing the bell like after we get up to this point again.
So am I good to use that shortcut I just unlocked, or...
Yeah, you can use that shortcut.
Yeah, you opened up the main gate.
Okay.
Also, notice that polite, helpful message telling you that, you didn't discover any small bells, so it gave you your insight back.
That's new!
Yeah, I noticed that last time. I noticed that last death, too.
Yeah, that's new.
It wasn't like that when we played. Although I'm genuinely surprised that From would include such a user-friendly thing.
Just out of curiosity, does that message show up even if I were invaded? Actually, I don't suppose you'd know since that's new to you guys.
Right. Oh, I love that giant mallet. It's like she was prepping to play whack-a-mole.
Whack-a-argate.
Whack-a-gate.
Whack-argate.
Well, Brickman did, so...
Alright, now I'm happy. Whack. Whack, whack.
Oof.
I swear I'm not trying to do this.
So you know you don't have to fight her, right? Right? The gate's open. You could have walked past her and she never would have bothered you again.
I know, but might as well since she's right there.
Yeah, it's gonna make dying with 27,000 echoes all the sweeter.
Well, it's the principle of the thing. She had the audacity to throw a Molotov at you. Ooh.
Maybe that's why I keep using audacity and not switching over. Come on, uppercut. Oh.
Oh.
Splunge.
You seem to be having trouble with this whole parrying thing.
It just, it clicks really well for some enemies and not with others.
It's largely because... I think because this enemy is armored. Parries occasionally work.
Well, no, it's the timing is a bit off because some of those swings are just real slow and...
Yeah.
And then you get the ones that are just instant gratification.
I get that. I bet that that third hit in that combo, the junk punch, I bet that really hurts.
Probably. You want to read a story, Liquidy?
So this person works at a sub sandwich place. It's a closing shift. I'm alone. It's about 10 minutes until I can lock the door and finish the closing duties. Suddenly, I hear the doorbell ring. Come out to the front, only to see a young police officer standing next to the door. Before I even get a chance to greet him, he asks, "Hey, did you happen to see a guy with a gun come in here?" He's trying to be sort of nonchalant so that I wouldn't freak out, but it's sort of hard to stay calm when asked a question like this. No, I answer. I am immediately on high alert and panic is rising quickly. Oh, okay. Don't worry about it, everything is fine. And then he hurried back to his car. I have a minor freakout for the next 10 minutes until I lock the door, and then had to work up the courage to walk out to my car once I'd finished up. And that's the story of how I almost had a heart attack at the tender age of 18.
Nice.
That's a good story. I like that story.
That one's pretty cute.
All right, you want to take a second and ring the bell again real quick, just to see?
Yeah, let me hop inside here.
Where they will not follow you.
Safe.
Until they do follow you.
Nah, it was safe. I ducked in just far enough so that he wouldn't come, so he would lose his attention.
Let's see if we can get the attention of the bell ringing woman this time.
Yeah. Hi, buddy.
Yeah, she would usually show up right away.
You know, it's not gonna last long enough if you keep fighting like that.
I know. Wow, he just destroyed that tombstone.
Well, if you hit a tombstone with something that was essentially a giant slab of steel on a stick,
yeah.
Wouldn't you expect it to crumble a little?
Good point. There we go.
Alright, so what did we learn about dogs?
They're adorable.
Don't fight them all at once.
Hug the dogs.
Oh, someone's co-oping.
Just for experimentation's sake.
Okay.
I see dogs.
I do too.
Mini dog.
There we go. Yep, you have to have a.
Oh, okay, yeah, you have to.
So that's an NPC invader then?
No, it's not. It's not an NPC invader. It's a woman who rings a sinister bell that can draw invaders.
Uh-huh.
You know, the sort of invaders who might have been trying to get into your game.
There we go.
What is that in your right hand?
Oh, that's the stake driver. I was using that to punch Bloodstarved Beast.
Ah. Looks really cool.
It's basically a bladed power fist.
Nice.
Yeah, I don't know if there's another. And that's what you're here for, isn't it?
That is.
I suppose so.
That is, in fact, why we want to check out the path of the dog.
Do I have to set those over at the dream?
Yeah, that's something you can't use, and you have to set up in the dream.
You can worry. Okay. You can worry about it later.
Yeah, worry about it later.
I'm inclined to say worry about that now because I got a bunch of echoes, but Liquidy's here, so let me
rephrase that. You literally cannot do anything with it yet.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you want to go back and cash in your souls, so be it. But
that's a huge waste.
Yeah.